Microbes. Welcome to the world of microbes. A massive population of microorganisms is too small to see with the naked eye. These are everywhere. But before you panic about the fact that they are presently inhabiting your body, it is important to understand that they typically do much more good than harm. We see many living things around us. Microbes are everywhere. They are in the air, in water, in the soil, and of course inside us. They are so tiny that hundreds of them can fit into a space occupied by a full stop. They can be seen under a microscope. They are called microorganisms or microbes. They grow and multiply rapidly. When a large number of microbes grow together at a place, they can be seen. Kinds of microbes. There are four main kinds of microbes: bacteria, protozoa, fungi, and viruses. Bacteria. Bacteria are the most widespread living things on the earth. They are found everywhere. They are associated with all the living things. They are 10 to 100 times larger than viruses. Bacteria are single-celled living things. They can be rod-shaped, bacillus, corkscrew-shaped, vibrio, or spherical, coccus. Some bacteria make their own food through photosynthesis, but most of them live on dead matter as saprophytes or living things as parasites. Protozoa. Protozoa are tiny, single-celled living things. They are bigger than bacteria. Most of them live in water. Others live as parasites in the bodies of plants and animals. Amoeba and paramecium move rapidly and flexibly because they do not have cell walls. Fungi. Fungi are plants. They lack chlorophyll. Hence, they cannot make their own food. They live on decaying matter, as well as living plants and animals. Only about half of all known fungi are harmful. Common fungi include molds, mushrooms, and yeasts. Viruses. Viruses are smaller than bacteria, ranging from about 20 to 400 nanometer in diameter. They are found everywhere. They become active when they enter the body of a plant or animal. They do not die for many years. Harmful microbes. Some bacteria cause diseases like typhoid, tuberculosis, pneumonia, plague, and cholera. Some fungi cause skin diseases like ringworm and food poisoning. Fungi may cause many diseases in plants, such as red rot in sugarcane, fruit rot in apple. Viruses cause diseases like common cold, flu, diarrhea, chicken pox, measles, mumps, rabies, polio, yellow fever, swine flu, and AIDS. Protozoa causes amoebic dysentery, diarrhea, sleeping sickness, and malaria. Useful microbes. Some bacteria break down dead plants and animals to give nutrients to the soil, which are good for the growth of plants. Some bacteria change milk into curd. Some bacteria also help to make cheese and vinegar. Some proteins extracted from bacteria are used in laundry starches and detergents. We eat certain mushrooms. Some mushrooms are also used to flavor food. Yeasts are added to dough to make bread rise. Molds are fungi that are added to soya beans to make soya sauce. Useful fungi, Penicillium notatum, is used to make antibiotics. Defenses against microbes. Microbes grow everywhere. They can attack us and also our food. As they grow, they break down the food and result in producing unpleasant smell and appearance. This is food spoilage. So we have to protect ourselves and food from microbes. At home, we should keep ourselves clean and also our surroundings clean. We should eat fresh fruits and vegetables. We should prepare and store food in hygienic conditions. We should eat food soon after preparation and keep leftovers in our refrigerator. We should properly boil milk to kill harmful microbes in it. In food industry, today, many food products are available in packets and bottles. They are free from harmful microbes. Certain methods are followed to process and store these food products. This is called food preservation. Milk available in packets is free from harmful bacteria. It is done by pasteurization. Pasteurization is the process of heating milk to kill harmful microbes in it. In hospitals, microbes grow in wounds. To kill these microbes, antiseptics are used. Heat above a certain temperature kills all bacteria. In hospitals, surgical instruments are heated to kill bacteria. This method is called sterilization.